Good morning. Welcome back to the Missouri Farm, located just outside of Alma, Missouri. It's the beginning of July. We're out inspecting the cornfield while getting King his exercise. Already rode rain this morning. Got alfalfa here to my right. And then this is our oat field over to our left. It's ready to harvest. So we'll have to go get the combine out and get started on that. I wonder if the horse does crop destruction. I have no idea if it would. I'm going to avoid the, the crops. If you look up in the upper right, the money is out of control. We made a ton of money yesterday. We sold the dried corn. And that was worth probably about $240,000. We were doing some baling contracts. The last one that we did was for silage bales. We got 140 bales off that field. And then the excess bales that we sold, we got probably, what, another $75,000. And then the payment for the contract was $50 less the cost of the equipment, which I'll throw that screen up real quick right now. So I had all sorts of ideas of what I could do with that money. I was in my head buying equipment and all kinds of things, but I think the best thing to do would be buy land. And there's a large field just west of the place that kind of borders the field that we have in soybeans. Right around the back side of the bins here, and that's about $550,000. So I don't know, we're close. We can maybe get a loan for it, or maybe we could make enough doing some contracts in the month of July to be able to buy it before August. The field's got sorghum in it right now, which should be ready to go, ready to be harvested come August. I think it's got sorghum in it. What's it look like? Yeah, that's sorghum. Isn't it? Yeah. And it's a good sized field, so whatever crop we get off of it would be, you know, good to help pay down however much we paid for it. So yeah, without further ado, let's get King put away. Oh, as if I didn't have enough of the bale handling yesterday. When I got back last night, before it got dark, I picked up the bales out of the kind of the yard area, you know, immediate environs of the farm. It's still out between the fields, but we'll go get those too. But I didn't want them to create dead spots in the grass. Where'd you go, King? There you go. Get King groomed. There we go. Horses are exercised. Check the animal menu here quick, make sure everything's good. Okay, there's rain and king. Yep. Okay. Let's swing by the cows real quick. Might as well. That's where it starts stacking the hay bales. Right there to the right. The cows have plenty of feed. They've got kind of hay and alfalfa hay. For whatever reason, their health's not coming up, which I find incredibly annoying, but we'll try and start feeding them total mix ration maybe after most of that hay's gone. Kind of wanted to get away from it, but the health thing concerns me just a little. I know they're not going to die or anything, but still. Alright, so we got to get the head out, right? It's going to maneuver it past the tractor. I'm going to have to move the tractor anyway, but get the combine out. Yeah, I should be right. I think I gotta fuel the combine up. I think we're really low on fuel. Look at our fuel gauge. Pretty low. Fuel this up before we get started. Hopefully we have enough. There we go, I can see it against the gravel. Still falling. There we go. It's been adjusted for oats, so we're ready to go. It's gonna fit across the bridge. I don't think will. I didn't think about that. Yeah, I didn't think about that. That's embarrassing. Field was corn last time I did it, and we have the Capella Diamante, I guess it is, header. It folds up, so I didn't think of this. Okay. Let's get this out of the road. Straw swath is, I don't know, let me check that. You don't see anything change on this one, do you? You don't. The ones that you can actually see something change, that way you kind of know whether it's set on straw swath or not. Alright, so we're going to need the baler, aren't we? Harvest and oats. This will be nice. This will give us base food for the horses. And also we can use oats with the seed treatment auger and produce seed. In addition to sometime selling the oats, I guess. Straw off the field. Let's see. How are we doing on straw? We can sell all our old straw bales. And have some fresher straw. Nice if some contracts came up. Well, earlier, I think I looked when I first got up and there wasn't anything. There should be. Some fields around. So ultimately, I think for the size of the farm, I'd like to acquire all of the fields kind of encompassed by these roads, this road here, north-south road to our east, the road to our south, there's a tree line to our west, and then the tree line with the railroad tracks to our north. I'd like to get all the land in that area, and that would be our ground that we work. I think we'll get two headlands in, especially on the north side there where that kind of waterway is. That drainage, a little creek. Give us sufficient room to turn around down there. So yeah, I was looking at the money, I'm thinking, oh, I want to get a grain cart, I want to get a bobcat, I want to get a gooseneck trailer, I want to get heads for the other combine, I want to get a sprayer, I want to get, I want to build a building. That's where we ended up driving through the crop to fertilize it. Too early. Lifted it just a hair too soon. Premature header left hitch. Yeah, this ditch on this side of the road's a little steep too, so I think I want to have two headlands on this side of the field as well. So we'll just go around twice. Get the truck. Probably sometime along this run. I don't think we'll get to the road before we'll fall. Well, maybe. Let's see. sure how much more I'm going to get out of this field. And that little diamond or this thing kind of ended up kind of odd, but I think we might be able to fit it all in one trailer load, which I'm not sure is a great thing. I'd prefer to have more. Of course, oats produces less volume than the other cereal crops, really. And it's worth more. Of course, we're going to use it to feed the horses and also to make seed. I don't know if we're going to sell any of it. Tank, so I think it's all gonna fit in one trailer. I didn't move the auger to put into the bin. I think I would have been prepared for this. I don't know, I can't explain it. Explain why I make the decisions I make sometimes. Once we get this into the bin, I suppose we can probably come down here and bale the straw unless we find something better to do. And then I'm tempted to sell. I don't know how much we'll get. Tempted to sell a trailer load of straw bales, which would be, I think, 18. We'll have to see what we get off here. I want to sell the old stuff that we have. And maybe complete the trailer off of this field and then keep some. I don't know how much we will need, really. We've got the cow barn full of straw, and there's only 36 out of many, many cows that it could hold. So I don't think we'll run low. Another thing we need to get a manure spreader and a slurry spreader, I guess. Check out that slurry lagoon, see how much slurry's in there. us probably, what, two more passes and we should be done. Grab the truck and get it all loaded. Actually, I wonder if we'll be able to empty the grain tank on the combo. I don't have a lot of space left in the truck. Trailer, nope. Powered. Nah, I should have brought the auger in. Oh well. Secured. Yeah, I want to put it in this bin over here. Okay, I kind of eyeballed where I needed to park, I think. Way too much of an angle. All right, think I can swing it. Yes, I think. Come on. How about that? I think I'd pull the truck up, it'd probably be the easiest thing to do. There it goes. Oh yeah, I don't know. Right there. That's it. Actually, the easy thing to do would be to bring the combine up, empty the combine into the trailer, and then dump it. That's probably what I'll do. The mower's not in the way. Okay, we'll get the last of that. swing it out of the way here. If we can. Nice. Perfect. Excellent. All right, baler. Can I get to the baler? Probably not. Nope. Weight off. Got that extra view because of the CSZ pack. Hang on. There we go. Of a hay bale. Bummer. Wants to be straw, I guess. Okay. Time to do some more baling. I guess we're going to get straw, whether we want it or not. Turn it on, drop it down. Instantly turned to straw. Bummer. Such it is. Hmm. I'm gonna try something. I'm gonna try and put these in pairs so they're easier to pick up. Since I can carry one with me, I'll just carry it until I need to drop it off. Push them together. There we go. It'll pull it back apart, won't it? Yeah. Oh well. That's okay. Alright, I'm gonna bale some straw. Might take a little bit. Okay, I'm going up the final windrow of straw left by the combine in a swath for us. Got some specks here and there around the field. I'll probably run around, try and pick them up. I'll edit that part out and I'll meet you at the corner of the field. Got it done. Maybe we'll try and figure out how many bales we got. Yeah. It's also lunchtime, so we'll head up to the house, grab something to eat, evaluate where we're at. Probably take a look at how we're doing in the episode. It's what I'd like to potentially do. Well, we'll check to use equipment. I believe there is a contract for baling for hay bales. Because if we haven't dunning off of that. It's the only contract that I saw, though, to be honest. So maybe we'll do that. Take a look at the prices of straw. Maybe we'll take a trailer load of straw to the animal dealer, and then probably get ready for tomorrow and keep an eye out for more contract opportunities. Okay, I think I got it all. It's kind of a waste of time. I don't know how long it took us, but I went from like 16% of a bale to 22% of a bale. So there wasn't a whole lot, and it probably took me about 15 minutes, guessing, game time. Anyway, let's take the baler back up to the yard, and let's go get something to eat. I think we got about 32 straw bales off that field. We'll have to see how many we have up over here. But certainly we've got enough to sell a trailer load, even though the price may not be very good. Get my weight again. That way I can handle two bales. I can do one without the weight, but I'm gonna use both spikes on the bale spikes. Then, yeah, I'm better off having the weight. But we're gonna head in the house, grab something to eat. Kind of hungry. Okay, I had kind of a quick lunch there. I know it's only 1 o'clock. We weren't in there very long, so I was taking a look at things, trying to figure out what we could do. And right now, we want to make money, and we want to buy that field over there. So we don't have enough, so we need to look at contracts to make some more money. So this field, which is sorghum right now, pretty good sized field. Let me walk over here. I'm gonna pull up the map. We'll talk through what I'm planning on doing. You see that over there? That's a canola field. I'd like to get that land too. Everything over to that tree line and up to the north there. So let's take a look at the map real quick. Let's talk about it and do some planning. Okay, so here's the farm. This is the map. We're talking about what field one is the one I want to get. So let me pull up farmland. It's plot two. It's going to cost $554,000. This is probably about $75,000 more than what we have. Okay. And this field here, field three, is only $44,208. The danger is that's ready to harvest right now. So I could buy it, harvest that canola, store it until what, October, when we need to harvest our corn and our soybeans. I could sell it then because I won't have bin space, because I got oats in that one. I'll put corn in that one, and I'll put soybeans in that one. Or I could deliver the corn straight off the field to the corn dryer, but that's a lot of carting I don't necessarily want to do. Maybe I can get some help. If I get a pace setter by then, maybe we could. Let me buy that field. All right, so buy for $44,208, yes. Okay, so now that field's ours. Our plan is to go in the middle of July, mid-July, and we're gonna go harvest that field, okay? And then to make money, and I wanna buy this in July as well, before the end of July. So we're gonna accept this one. We're not gonna borrow items, accept that one. And then we're going to borrow items for this one. And then we're going to accept this one. And we can only have three. I'd like to accept that one, but I can't. I got three active contracts. So what I'll do is when I finish first contract, I'll try and take this one too. We'll use our own tether to ted it. But yeah, so that's the idea. Crazy. It took too long to explain all that. Alright, well, anyway, we're out of time. I'm going to have to do a lot of that on my own. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please hit that like button. If you don't subscribe yet, why not? Don't cost nothing. We'll see you next time.